有一军人身带弓，只言我是白头翁，东边门里扶金剑，勇士后门入地宫。
Please watch on for Prophecy of the Golden Age Part 98, The Great Saint in the Chinese Prophecies.
观人类历史，神圣的讯息常笼罩在神秘的事物中。先知、弥赛亚，无论你怎么称呼他们，他们常受迫害与压迫，他们的话隐晦不明。但我们如何分辨真假？要做到这点，人们只能仰赖上天的引导，而真理将向那些认真寻求他的人揭示。
现在让我们继续探索这本由西元七世纪中国的李淳风和袁天罡所合著的图解预言书《推背图》中所描述的救世主。我们从上一集节目开始研究第四十六象。这则卦象说，尽管救世主会拯救成千上万的人，意思是指无数的人，但他本身却是难逃。
万人不死，一人难逃。
Any real master have hell, even not die, but die and live again, die and live again. You know, sometimes.Sick or something, like 90% almost die already and then come back again.
青海无上师自展开自己的使命以来，多次差点丧命。师父除了在旅途中，甚至在自己的道场中，需面对危险的情况或民众之外，他还得忍受危及性命的病痛与危险的手术。师父说，这些可怕而且完全不公平的磨难，是他为了拯救灵魂所需付出的代价，这样才能改善他们的命运。
Every part of a master, a true master, has an invaluable price for special things, okay, to upliftthe planet, to uplift the people consciousness. So if she hurt on the eyes or he is operated on the stomach, there are special purposes. Yeah? Every part of a true master has a valuable power to help people, the souls of people to be uplifted and enlightened and to help the planet to be more kind. People consciousness go up,then the world will be more kind, more peaceful. Every part of the master body is for sacrifice.
那时是2009年，大约在丹麦哥本哈根举行联合国气候变迁会议之际，我们的星球因为世界累积了极深重的恶业而面临即将毁灭的灾厄。为了拯救地球，师父牺牲了自己，而且毫不保留地捐出灵性功德，为人类的恶业付出代价。
I have two dreams.
Yes.
And the one is that you ask me to give you massage, and then I see black and blue all over your body.
Mm-hmm.
And then you have wounds on the flesh. It's like big as this, like chi money. It's like big, like this.
Okay.
And the next
on the flesh,
time,
on
yeah,
the body.
The next time, and you ask me to press the renzhong that is here.
Mm-hmm.
That is only when your life is in danger. In the Chinese, you press here.
Press here. Yeah,
yeah, it's like that.
Okay.
So I know how much you suffer. That is also during your, you're in hospital or you.
That time.
The Copenhagen. Okay, okay. Yeah.
Yeah.
You see, because before I was just so intense in helping mankind and saving the world and the planet that I did not even think of myself. But even then, at that time I thought, that's it, I give even if I die. If I go to hell, I would give anyway. At that time I thought I would go to hell. I was very sick. As the Copenhagen is going on there, I was very ill in the hospital. Serious illness. Very serious, could not even move for many months, and terrible pain, can't even get up from bed. It was terrible, and I thought I would die anyway. But then heaven took pity on me and let me live and continue to work. But they have warned me to keep some minimum for myself, and they have helped to find a way to multiply my spiritual points since then. So it's very good, very good. I'm very lucky to stay alive and going strong spiritually.
师父在2012年透露地球的期限已延长更多年了，这是他密集闭关并代表我们的世界向天堂请命的结果。因此不止万人，而是百万亿众生，包括未来世代都已获救。
其实中文习惯说万这个字来表示数量非常多的意思，
但对于我们挚爱的师父来说，这代价却极高。
Master, could we know what happened to you when you negotiated to save the planet and what price you had to pay for that?
Physical price.
What kind of physical price, Master?
Cut up the whole body.
Oh my God. Master.
Truly, I'm very tough. I don't know if any woman tougher than I am. Working so much and I'm still okay, so I don't worry about it. Yeah. Getting better all the time. More strong, more powerful. That's why I can avoid so many attempts on my life. I go when I want to go. I live when I want to live. So don't worry about me. Whatever I don't allow, it won't happen. And if I do allow, then it's for your good. I'm here just for the good of others.
The 46th 语言图仿佛在阐释师父所言，该图把这位救主描绘成坚强的战士，这位架势十足准备就绪的武士，看似充满勇气与决心。我们还注意到背景中的竹子，中文字竹的发音与竹字完全相同，这可能意味着救世主已经下定决心，准备把所有否定的力量与众生逐出我们的世界，这正是青海无上师一直在做的事。此卦象的颂论部分确实把这位救主描写成一位军人。宋曰：有一军人身带弓，只言我是白头翁。青海无上师的确像一位战士般捍卫并拯救无助的灵魂，他没有使用任何武器，只用自己的爱与光对抗无明与否定的力量。的确，宋论还说这位军人拥有白头，意指白发，白发象征极高的智慧。这位救主拥有超凡的智慧，因为他是大开悟的名师。
The disciples don't know the danger of being a master. They're too safe because master protects them all the time. The master power. So they feel nothing happened to them. The soldiers who has to protect the country. The country citizens are safe, but the soldier is not safe anytime. Everything can hurt the soldiers because he's a soldier. He's in danger all the time. And that's how you are safe. But nobody understands that. Very rare. Yeah? Because he's safe with the soldier.
后，我们这些青海无上师的弟子在生活中都有绝对的安全感，这是因为有师父每天的护佑，他带走了我们的业障和恐惧感。
Vous avez trop souffert pour nous.
Ah, ça va. Comment vous savez?
J'ai vu ça dans la méditation.
Ah.
Et il y a deux hommes avec coupe-coupe qui voulaient, qui couraient derrière moi.Et vous m'avez dit de partir, et vous avez pris le devant. J'ai dit, Master, on va vous couper. Non, je vais rester avec vous. Vous m'avez dit, non, partez, partez. Et vous vous êtes donné. Le monsieur, quand il a pris coucou sur vous, vous avez disparu du coup.
Oh.
Et je suis partie, Master. Master, merci infiniment.
Super.
师父对徒弟的这个这种保护那种爱大爱心，这个是没话说了啊。在七股印心的时候，那如果这个求印心的同修，他有累世的这个因果业报在，师父为了救他的这个身体与灵体，他一摸到他的智慧眼的时候。占据在这个求印者的肉体上的会跑出来，那跑出来就会往师父的头部、脸部、背部一直打，哦，他用性命去保护这个，那个是虽然是无形的，他打到师父印完心，真的都是瘫痪了一样的，哦，这个是我亲眼看到的，哦，所以我非常非常心疼。这个师父为了徒弟的印心，这样牺牲。
七月中旬，记得有一次，师父在后山的相思林为新同修印心时，弟子打坐看到满满无形众生一直攻打师父，师父好可怜，手持一只细长的金银色拐杖防着。当时弟子心里好难过，一直想跑过去挡住那些无形众生，可是弟子只有凡夫能力，没办法帮师父。等等，46相的颂论最后写道：东边门里扶金剑，勇士后门入地宫。金剑可能是指救主的灵性武器，神圣之光。东边门里扶金剑，也许是指太阳升起的东方，代表崭新的一天，或新时代的来临。地宫可能是指生生世世又来困住所有灵魂的三界，为了拯救低境界的无助灵魂，救主必须隐藏自己的力量与荣光，才能从后门潜入魔王的领地。
You have to learn all kinds of things. You learn how to survive. You learn how to teach people, but have to survive also. Otherwise, you die in no time.The moment you offer yourself to help other people elevate spiritually, that moment Maya already on you. Never leave you alone.
So you have to learn even the art of a spy. 007. That's nothing. You have to be 008, a knight. Yeah? 009, yeah? Yeah.
Well, that's the price to pay for doing what the master is supposed to do. It's like if you are an undercover spy or agent in an enemy country or area, you're not allowed to have too many things, yeah? You're not equipped with all the comfort, instruments, and privilege or help that you have, you would have in your own country, yeah? Even if you are a king there, you're mostly on your own, so to speak. The Chinese people know, you know, like for example, the king Qinlong or the king Kangxi, many times they disguise themselves as commoners to go around checking out local officials and citizens to try to understand their own people or to root out or to mitigate corruption, you know, in the lower level of officials to try to find out injustice anywhere to help their subjects. And while traveling around the country, they had only a couple of assistants with them. They could not tell any local officials or reveal their identities. They got into troubles or dangers often because of that. But they couldn't be as protected as if they were in their palace. Still, they did it because they loved their subjects and endure all hardships or trials for them, for their sake, because they want to try to make their lives better. That's love.
我们刚才听到师父这首感人的诗作，概述了他这位最慈悲的神圣众生所肩负的使命。他为了这个世界，甘愿放弃自己神通广大的力量。尽管如此，他仍勇往直前，追求地球上的和平，把受困的灵魂救渡至天堂。感谢亲切的观众今天的收看，下周请再度锁定本节目。